box defense as the Lightning sets up. Here's McIver to the left side to Francis. Now Lemieux crosses the ice, goes to the left wing boards, back to Francis. Now he gives it back to Mario, to Francis again. Somebody's got to shoot it. That's scored. The Penguins get the first goal of the game. Ronnie Francis drilled it. It might have been touched on the way in, but if it was, it was by a Tampa Bay player, and the Penguins strike first. Now get in the fast lane, Grandma. The bingo game is ready to roll. Ron Francis.
It's absolutely amazing the way the Penguins continue to generate goals on the power play, and this is without Sergei Zubov, and this is a message early to the Tampa Bay Lightning to stay out of the box tonight. Last night, they were shorthanded 9 times against the Philadelphia Flyers, and the only 2 goals the Flyers got came on their power play. So they're going to have to be careful tonight against Pittsburgh to remain disciplined and not take penalties like the one Ciccone takes that gives the Penguins a 1-0 lead on the power play goal by Ron Francis.
And we'll take another look at it. McIver, 29 seconds on the power play. Skates over to the left wing corner to Ron Francis. In front to Sandstrom, turning around to Yager. It's behind him. Yager again with it. Look at it. Left side to Lemieux. Yes, they do have to shoot it. Lemieux giving it to Francis now. Back their side to Yager, to McIver. What's he going to do with it? He'll give it to Yager. Moves in. Doesn't pull the trigger. Left side. Now to Lemieux. Holding it. Walks in. Score! Mario Lemieux puts it, makes it off Bergeron, and the Penguins have made it 2-0. Ah, great balls of fire again, showing the patience. Smith's patience is as Mercy Hospital has. Unbelievable.
I think Sampson's going to get the goal here. He set him up in front. All he had to do was tap it in. That was your basic layup for Thomas Sandstrom. With Lemieux just laying it over there, they finally got the two-on-one situation down low that they were looking for. That's basically what you do when you pass it around all that much, the way the Penguins were doing. And Yager ran some interference in there also. He blocked out on one of the Lightning players in front and basically made it possible. That is a pick, really, is what he did there. It made it possible for Lemieux to get the puck through the Sandstrom. See Yager there blocking out on Ciccone? Sandstrom just tapped it right underneath Bergeron to make it 2-0.
I think that's Francis, too. The power play chances they have had. They sneak it over to Yager, try to go cross ring, comes right to Lemieux. Look at that play. Lemieux back to Francis, shoots it in front, deflected by Sandstrom in the net. The Penguins lead 3-0. Now Carl Arnold Slick from Turtle Creek. Thomas Sandstrom gets his second, his 10th of the year, and the Penguins now lead 3-0. Well, the Penguins got a break. The puck bounced right across, but right to the stick of Mario Lemieux as his 3rd point of the game.
And Lynn Vaughn of Pittsburgh picks up 2 tickets to a future Penguins game. Lemieux got Chiron to drop to the ice, dished it off to Francis at the top of the circle, and he kind of drove that puck to the net where Sandstrom could deal with it and steer it right behind Bergeron. Watch Lemieux with this little move right here. Look at Chiron. He's down. That's the same thing that Holder did earlier, going down trying to block the pass. So Lemieux just went out to the Francis, who then went down to Sandstrom, and it's 3-0, and the Penguins have another power play.
They go down in front of Yager. Hey! Schultz and scores! Jaromir Jagr makes it 4-for-4 on the power play, and the Penguins have a 4-0 lead. Now the count kick. Making 4 points for Lemieux in period number one.
And number 8 for Jagr. And now,
making 4 points for number 10 also, Ron Francis.
Look at that. Cullen was there, and he just had to watch Jagr dump it in, and so did Roman Hammerlick. Well, Roman Hammerlick had a little visitor this summer for a week. Jaromir Jagr stayed at his house. Maybe he won't invite him back.
After this. Well, here comes Darren Pupa to replace J.C. Bergeron. I'll tell you, he hasn't got a whole lot of help. He's come storming back. Lemieux slows the pace down, trying to pull it around the defenseman cross. He does come into the zone. Reaching for it, Francois Leroux, a shot, the puck, it goes in. Marcus Naslund got a piece of it, and it hopped over Bergeron, and the Penguins have a 5-0 lead. Oh, look out, Leroux. And Lemieux, I think, will get another assist. Maybe. He may have touched that puck on the way back towards Francois Leroux. He reached in. I don't know if he touched it, but Leroux fired the puck, and I think Naslund deflected it.
I believe so, too. It sure looked that way. Naslund was around the net, and LaRue's shot was from so far out, it's hard to imagine it beating Bergeron. Look at Lemieux in here. Does he touch the puck? It's hard to tell whether he got a piece of that or not. LaRue drove it back. It was not Naslund. It was a Tampa Bay player who deflected it into his own net. So big Frankie LaRue will pick up the goal.
And the Penguins strike with their fifth.
Bergeron can't get a break from his own team.
On Burr. If he had the speed, he'd have been home free on a breakaway. That allows the Penguins to recapture it. Jagr going through people, walking to the net, trying to put it in. Bergeron stopped it. Did they go in or not? The puck apparently has crossed the line. Jagr puts it in the goal, and the Penguins now lead 7-0. Tanhol, Bicoltura, Jaakko Cigarettu.
And as he would say, smoke him like a bad cigar. Jagr did it all himself. And now it's Bergeron who's got the headache. Watch this pass by Mario Lemieux that sent Jagr off to the races. And, you know, when you get an assist on like this, it's pretty amazing because the guy makes a great play, but it still was a tremendous pass by Lemieux. He led him in perfect stride, and then he just did the rest, just completely undressing Eric Chiron, who tried his best to stay with it, and he stayed with it so much that he took it into the net. Look at Chiron. Jagr just dancing around him. Did get a stick on it one last time, and then Chiron knocked it into his own goal. That's the kind of night it's been for the Lightning.
Back to 5-on-5. Here's Klima with it, shooting right to the net. I think the reason why, because Bob Hodges they did not come up with the right call. Here's Lemieux back 2-on-1. He's got a chance to tie this record if he sets it up. He's got to take a shot himself. It's his 7th point of the game. The Penguins now lead 10-0. Vince C wants to sell my monkey. Wow, what a night for Mario Lemieux.
And that was your basic 2-on-1, which he turned into a 1-on-1 situation on the goaltender, J.C. Bergeron.
You know, this will be a night J.C. Bergeron will remember the rest of his life.
Look at Lemieux push that puck past Peter Klima. That soft little touch. One man back. Is Eric Chiron. He puts him to the ice and then fires it up on the glove side of Bergeron. Eric Chiron was down and out.
Number 66. Lemieux now with 6.